All right, here we go. 2022 Topps Chrome Update Baseball Case Break Number 1. These are your squads. Thank you, everybody. Good luck to you. Alrighty, I think we are set. So you know, Topps Chrome Update. They write it right on the box for you. Yeah. Topps. Wonder if Topps knows what they have. These codes don't actually mean anything. Maybe to them, but not online. Like, print what's on the case. Like, what's in it? I shouldn't have to open it to know. I want to leave it sealed. I'll make my own label. I don't want to write on the box. It's like writing on a card.
This is a variation.
Like, it takes 10 seconds to print a label. Like, just print the label. Stick it on there. Come on, let's go. All right, there will be a big recap at the end. If you don't want to watch the beginning, pack openings, that's fine. Gonna open them all up, get the cards naked, and getting on a roll. Ooh, I don't think I did Topps Chrome this year either. I opened some. I opened a bunch when I was at the Texas shop. They're starting to hit their stride. I'm really happy for them. These build outs and permits and licenses and all this crap takes way too long. Just let me get my stuff in a store and let's go. You want your money, government, or not? Give me my piece of paper that says I can do business, and then GTFO, my way. Definitely seeing all the purple they were talking about. Somebody tell me a story. This chat is so dead. Come on. Give me something. Tell me your cat punched your dog and your dog ran away. I don't care. Say something. Supposed to be enjoying this together. Good Lord. Shiny purple is better than dull purple. That's what I say. Well, the guys that we found are from the Napa area. We like Burbank and we like a lot, and we what's the other one out there? Damn it, I can't remember the name right now. But we didn't want to go into their market. I know LA and Southern California is huge and it would be sustainable, but California in itself is already a pain in the ass to try to open a business in. So we didn't want to open up and be dead in the water. Total available market was much better in Northern California. It's been horrible. Oh my God, it's been so bad. One thing after another. We had a damn tree growing through the walls. They opened the walls up for the inspection, and there was literally a tree growing through the studs inside of the wall. Like, you don't know that going in. Ugh. Mm-hmm. Well, we did pick the three absolute hardest states to open a business in. New York, Texas, and California. Like, ugh. I know the Idaho Roadshow doesn't sound very appealing to anyone, but geez, I bet we could have had that one open in a week. Yeah, Texas is like its own little country. They have all their different state laws. It's really weird. Lending there is also a pain in the ass. I had to, with the mortgage banking, I had to get specialized license to lend in Texas. you had to go through a whole thing with each company you're at for them to allow you to do it so you can adhere to all the rules. And it's a pain in the ass. Texas is nuts. Texas is equally as nuts as New York and California in terms of how their state regulations differ from every other state. It's nuts. We think we're almost ready. We think we're almost there. We got one more permit to get or to pass. And hopefully we can actually open this. I feel bad for the Channels brothers. Like, they're doing everything. They're the guys that are going to run it. They've been doing everything they possibly can for over a year. There was a point where we thought Texas was going to be open, or California was going to be open for Texas. Texas has been open for 8 months. We've talked a bit about Southern California, Weevil. I want to focus a lot about what we got going on in Colombia. I think we're going to push. We're going to do a store in North Carolina. I think we're going to push that to second quarter. Then I want to go international, like not Colombia international, but Europe international. We need somebody to sell them carts. I think we know how to do it. Isn't that crazy, though? Wouldn't you want businesses? Like, what? Why would you make it hard to collect taxes? Like, that's your whole thing. Like, let's make all these rules and bullshit and so we can collect money. Like, you can't collect the money if you put all the rules in the way. All the actual good businesses are going to go somewhere else. Like, you know, Florida. They don't have state taxes. And things pretty loose. Easy to get. Yeah, dude, I know. It's a paradise corrupted by politicians. I don't normally do this, but under the pretense that we keep it straight up, no, I don't want to do it. We're not going to talk about politics. We're not going to talk about religion. As much as I'd love to, I didn't talk about you until I'm. Oh, God. I should just delete all my news feeds. It's probably horrible for my mental health. I don't really need to know. Like, it's cool to know and be in the know, but really actually something that's 4,000 miles away doesn't affect me. That much. Said that about Corona too. Well, at least it's not Oregon. Well, I've been to LA. I wouldn't pay to go back. I'd go back for work. Been to Tahoe a bunch. Doesn't actually really count, but that place is special. Salt Lake Tahoe. Flat tax rate. Good luck. Sure, everybody that works their ass off to make a shitload of money and employ people are going to be so happy to split taxes with people that don't. That's too logical. It sounds way too simple. I don't know. You gotta be some kind of special person to go into politics. Jeez. It's like growing up being like, you know what? I really want to be an awful used car salesman. Ryan, what you been up to lately? Anything new? New card additions? New family additions? Did you get a new job? Buy a new house? Did you do anything cool? Did you buy a dancing Tesla? Nobody knows. We've never done this to this scale before. Everyone thinks it should just be so goddamn easy. It's like, what? There's billions and billions of people. I don't know, man. I don't really get it. I don't know the ins and outs. However, I'm pretty good at right and wrong. And most of politics is wrong. Did you do some selling? I bet you made a killing. Oh, God. I wanted to just, like, every day annoy the crap out of you guys and be like, hey, your base cards that were worth negative money are now worth a crap load of money. Like, go sell it all. In 2 years, you can buy back everything you feel butthurt about. And you'll be in the green so hardcore. Oh my God. Oh yeah, baby. Yeah, grading finally came back down to, everything came back down to earth. Cards are not where they should be. I feel like they're a little below market, but think we're in a good place to move forward. The flippers are gone. The retail target hoarders are gone. The beast card graders are gone. They all went bankrupt. They're all done. Oh yeah, man. Gut punches for days. I mean, I went back and actually looked through my records. On 2017, Panini Prism Football, they had 10 cases on allocation and ended up making like $1,300 profit. I could sell one box and make that right now. I could sell like 5 packs and make that. Oh my God. Yeah, COMC is awesome. I love them. It's so easy. It's kind of fun too. You just add it to your morning routine, go in there, see what offers you have, what new cards popped. It's great. I love it. So easy. I think everyone should do it. It's more of a low end thing. It can be high, but ooh, nice Ty Cobb gold. Is that gold or is that just the insert? No, it's just the insert. It's nice looking. I dig it. Tapia. Are these purples numbered? Nah, no way. Pete Alonso. Connor Pinkleton. Pinkleton. A blue Luplow to $199. Yogi. Bobby Witt Jr. Nice. Dude, oh, those Giannis. Wonder. Talking about being paid off just to be a fan. Giannis. Jeez. Bryson Stott. Tim Anderson Refractor. Quintana. So it's stack very well. Altuve. Mike Trout, refractor. I don't know. This is the first I've opened of it in the group break. I did a couple of personal boxes for myself of straight up Topps Chrome, not update. Julio? Adam Frazier, our first auto. Mariners are on the board. Ron? Torkelson purple. Jay, what's up, brother? How you doing? Oh my God, that's a great job. Good job. I had weird stuff sitting around. That I never, ever would have paid attention to and only found out by accident. So every month, not anymore, but every month I would buy like $500 worth of junk wax just for like nostalgic fun purposes. And it's boring. Like, it's cool the first box or whatever, but you do a couple boxes and you're just bored. And they're all the same cards. But those started to go up. And I was like, what the hell? These are the last things that should go up. And then I started looking at singles sales. Like, what? Well, I bought all this stuff and they still have it. It's worth way more now. But I bought it to rip it, so I'm going to rip it. So I ripped it all and I graded it and I did great. But man, some of the stuff I had, like, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, like Ken Griffey Jr. rookies, like all of it is just all the junk that you would want and pay a decent price for was just going bonkers. Wisco, that's how they do it. Dominate chats. Let's go, Wisconsin. I lived in Wisconsin. I'm not 100% fib. Oh, you non-Wisconsin, Illinois people don't even know what we're saying. William Contreras. That'll go to the Braves. John. Dahapa. No one in the entire world does cheese curds better than Wisconsin. Good God. Wander Purple. Well, those things just make your knees weak. Oh, so good. There are two things from Wisconsin that I want desperately right now that I cannot get without actually going there. J-Rod Refractor. Spotted Cow, yes. That's number one. You know me too well. And cheese curds. That's it. That's all I want. And I can't get it. What the fuck? I can't buy beer from Wisconsin? Like, it's like the allocation game all over again. All right. Well, if I buy 1,200 cases of Busch Light, can I get one case of Spotted Cow? Yeah, Busch was a bad example. But you get my drift. Bobby Witt. Base. In case you're wondering why I'm putting those back up there. Base. I don't have anywhere to put them. I'm at home. I don't have a lot of room to work. Redoing the office. Set it up to be a little more break friendly. Rod. Ramos. Still in Florida. Jacksonville-ish area. Hunter Money Green. Corey Seager. Nice. Texas. Weibo. Expect to see one of those. Not bad. Not bad so far. So far, so good. Seager. Got a Wander Purple. Contreras. And I'm Frazier. Could definitely be worse. G-Rod. I, The card design's great. The chrome looks great. They pop. Just, I think by not getting those SPs in, they just gave 2022 Topps Chrome everything a bad name. Jazz. Bobby Witt purple. It's always weird to see Babe Ruth in a chrome product. Kyle Bradish, it's the 250. I don't want to find out, so I'll take your word for it. How bad is it, Jay, when you're opening a complete dud and you're just like, oh my God. Somehow I have to try to make this enjoyable. J-Rod Refractor. Aaron Judge. Wander Purple. Yeah. Sometimes it's not even trash. It's just something that you personally are not into. You know, like, I don't get it. This is dumb. That used to be Bowman for me every year. You're like, why am I doing this? This is so dumb. I hate these cards. I caught on. Manny Machado. Refractor, maybe variation, looks a little different. Nick Pavetta Aqua. Yep, it's like, oh my God, this is horrible. And now I have all this pressure all over me for trying to turn out this. God, it's the worst feeling. Hey, if you want to tell your guys, we have a ton of overstock. So if they want to buy anything, we can move it off to them if they want it. Send them a list if they want. Royce Lewis purple. Yeah, I know. It's horrible, right? Like, they're always watching. Someone's always watching you. Ugh. Ozzie Albies. That's nice. A nice diving slide in there. Hair's flowing. John Stevenson with the Braves. It's numbered to 125. Nice. He's fun to watch. Torque. Soto and Frazier.
Base.
Yes. I don't want to put it all on them, but if you look at what happened, the entire industry went from going straight up, and then Fanatics bought it, and it went straight down. So, yeah, there's been an impact. They bought a printing press. The printing press is not doing a great job. There's product delays. I know they'll get it right, but it's been really fucking hard. Like 2016 hard. Like they set us back a half a decade. And that's just change. It's not that they're doing anything malicious or wrong or whatever. They're trying to do the best they can do, but at the end of the day, they're entering a market that they don't understand. And they can try to handle or hire a bunch of people, but the people at the top don't collect cards. They don't know. People at the top aren't collectors. They're not going to know. Yes, you're a great business person. You could probably figure it out, but don't understand your market. And I know that'll take some time. And they'll figure it out. It took Panini a long time. About 4 or 5 years. Simon Musatti. Yes, there you go. It's, sorry, I read that after I already said it. But yeah, you're right. They went through the same thing, man. FedEx just went hard in the paint and tried to grab everything at once. No, no, they are not. They are very much not. Lots and lots of tough conversations with distributors. When you have distributors calling you to buy products from you, man, things have dramatically changed. Man, I didn't get enough of this. You got any coming? Yeah, I do. How much can I get? Well, if you buy 10 cases of Onyx from me, I'll give you one case of Prism. They're like, oh, well, what is that? No. Like, hey, man. You did it to me for a decade. Nah, I don't care about that. Except for one relationship we have, I hold very near and dear to my heart. But the rest of them can get it. You made your money. I hope you managed it right. Imagine sitting on like 50, $100 million of depreciating assets. Ugh. Did I miss the Pujols refractor? I leave it in the base deck? I don't think so. Probably pulled it. Third base. Yeah, I got it out. We're good. Probably in here somewhere. Soto? Or who? Who are we looking for? Pujols. That one? Yeah, that's a refractor. Is that a variation? No, it's the 299. Might be. It's nice. Little salute. Yeah, hit. That's why I like opening all the packs at once. You just rush through them and be like, boom, we're already on to the next box. Forget about how bad the last box was. You didn't even know it's just a big blend. Wonder Franco. Bobby Witt purple. Bo Sulzer, Orioles. Mike. How does breaking now affect your collecting, Jay, if at all? You get to see a lot of things that other people don't. the microphone. There we go. Bryce Harper? Me taking a break. I mean, it makes me sad, but it makes me happy too, because I've heard that a lot. And it was like, man, I miss my buddies. Bobby Wood Jr.? One day, I'll find you guys a couple of them. Really nice, chill, cool breaker that you'll enjoy. I think I got one. Going up, works in the Kentucky shop. I'm gonna go up there next week, spend some time with him. See what he wants to do with his future. Kyle Bradish, Orioles. He's a younger kid, which is great, because, I mean, you need all that energy. Adam Engel refractor. You guys, you say nice things to me, make me feel good. Appreciate you. Kind of awkward, actually. Do you guys have trouble taking compliments? I always have. Royce Lewis purple. Acuna. All-star game. Torque purple. No one ever compliments me. I'm sorry, Jay. I think you're a super awesome person. And you should hold on to that. Just be you. You guys want to play the compliment game? Whenever my kids are arguing, I always try to get them to play the compliment game. You have to only compliment each other. So, our recap. Probably not the best one. Picked out a lot of the rookies. Torque, Lewis, Witt, a real Witt. Lewis, Cruz, Torque, Lewis, Wander, G-Rod, Bobby Witt, G-Rod, Torque, Bobby Witt, a blue Jordan Luplow, and our autographs, Bradish, Sulcer to 125, Muziati, Albies,
it's a cool picture,
125, Corey Seager, Wander Franco Purple, William Contreras, and Adam Frazier. And that's it. That's it on this one. Thank you guys very much. We got number two coming up next. A bunch of new breaks in the store. NT Hoops, Five Star Baseball, XR, Capstone, Bowman Draft Light. Lots of good stuff. Oh, MLS Finest is starting to move. Yeah, buddy. I don't know who those players are, but that product has so much good color in it. All right, y'all. If you're not watching the next one, thanks for hanging out with me. I appreciate you joining the breaks. We'll catch you on the next one.